Hello to all of my BPTV fans, YouTube fans, and Facebook fans. I'm Alan Levine, the Talking Machine, and I'm doing another Speedy Gourmet show to inspire you. Let's get started. All right, we're started. One of my favorite fish for you today is sockeye salmon. And you don't have to say wild caught, because sockeye salmon is all caught, wild caught in Alaska. So we'll get it over here, rip a couple off, get it ready to wash. Little tape in there. All right, here, look at that nice cut. I bought a pound and had it cut three ways. That's about 4 ounces, 4.5 ounces. So it's not a huge piece. It just looks like it is. All right, let's get out our tray, our baking tray. We'll get out special rice cauliflower to save calories. And it's just like rice, and it tastes pretty good. I've had it before. All right. We're going to use some avocado spray, another healthy oil. Spray it on here. And we'll put that away. Whoop, pardon me. You get to see my cabinet there. All right, we'll put the fish right out there. Got a paper towel. Let's get some veggies. A new record for my butternut squash, 2 months. We may use a little spinach later, we will see about that. And oh, one more thing, can't forget this. My son got these great containers. Look how cool they are. Some onion, yellow squash, and zucchini. Broccoli coming up, Bella mushroom. So you got to get busy here. Let's get my knife. You know the story, 30-year-old Cutco knife, 30 years plus, very sharp. Zucchini's been washed. Oh, wait, that's a cucumber. That's for another meal. We got to get the zucchini. You can just start that back, so. All right, I cut the tip off. About 6 slices. Toss that tip away. Put that to the side. Let's see how many yellow squash we can get out of this. There we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 2 is 6. We're on a 6 method here. We got some onion. I was experimenting the other day. So we'll just cut it in half, and I'll try baking it to show you. I experimented the other day and it turned out pretty good. All right, butternut squash. Look at that. It's still holding up. We'll do a slice. And I'm cutting the thinner slices that seem to cook a little bit better. It's very tasty. I enjoy it thoroughly. I'm not like those pros on the Food Network. Oh, 1. Watch your fingers. Watch those fingers. I'm just trying to inspire you. All right, be careful with the knife. Open it up. And you see Bella mushrooms, I love them. you gotta get them. I'll get about four nice size ones and scrub all that bad stuff on them. Get a nice stream of water, take the stems out. Got those stems, give them a nice wash, set them. Wash it very nice. We're good to go. A little pat dry here. And we'll do a little slice. We'll put some mushrooms in here. I got too many veggies. I don't know if they'll all fit on here, folks. I think I underestimated this. Well, we'll just carry on. Just put them in there. All right, got room for one more. Mushrooms shrink a little when they're cooked, as you all know, being a cooker. And we'll get the butternut squash. That's the thinnest cut I've done on Speedy Gourmet, so it's a little new adventure for me to be a little more creative. And we spread them all out there nicely. And the oven's heated up at 465 with the electric ovens, as you all learn when you gotta have them. Doesn't cook as well. Okay, onions, here's my experiment. One, we'll put it a little angle there. Little creativity. I'm gonna battle getting all this in here. All right. Little breeze, 70 degrees out there, folks. We got the breeze. Well, we got this filled up pretty nicely. Look at that. We'll take this right into the oven here. Close the door. Step back. The oven's been preheating. Always preheat it. Step away. You don't want to get sunburned from the oven. You can get it outside today. Work on your suntan. We need those tans. All right. Let's see. I'm going to hold off on broccoli. I got plenty of veggies. We'll put the butternut squash in here. All right. Loose leaf green tea. My favorite, China gunpowder, right there for you. Pop it off. Great light grassy smell. And I'll bring it over there and show you how we load up the tea ball. Give Nick a better shot of me. You got to be careful now. Here's the tea ball. Get in there. And it's like sort of like a bead, and it opens up. And then you just go steady. Oh man, one of them. I missed it. There we go. All right, we're ready to go. Turn the Cuisinart on. Great gift from my daughter, Casey. It'll let us know when the tea is ready. Another gift from Casey. What a good daughter I have. You know what this is for if you've been watching. If you don't, thermometer. 145 on the salmon. 145. Take out a plate. We're good there. Get my cup ready. We'll do it so it's a little more convenient. Let's check that timer there. This iPhone does the, oh, we're good. Here's what we're gonna cook up. 90 seconds, so I'm gonna go not give it as much time. Very healthy, I showed you before. Gotta rip it here. And look, it opens up to let air in. And you put it in the microwave, 90 seconds. Normally 40 minutes, 90 seconds. Put it down here. It'll wait for us to come back. And salmon's one of the healthier fish that you can buy. I get mine at Fresh Thyme. And just the other day, I spent $13.99 on 1 pound. Got three nice cuts out of it, so we'll enjoy one of them today. Let me get this put away. There we go. We always try to clean up as we're going. Need a little drink. It's a little dry and warm in here. Sparkling water, Trader Joe's. I don't drink that tap water, except we got a filter. Just the way the water smells all winter, I'm not a happy camper with that. All right. We're doing great here. We might be on to a new record today, folks. I gotta check the timer again, because, wow, we're 10:25. 10 minutes and 25 seconds, so we're going. You hear the tea brewing? We'll take a little slice. And, all right, we'll get this going. I'm gonna get my ceramic pot. We're gonna fill it up with some water, and I'm gonna put some spinach. I'm gonna add a little spinach as a nice color with the salmon. So we turn this on, and we don't wanna boil it, we just wanna soften it a little bit and cook it a bit. Look at those leaves. We'll toss them in. See what else we got. Put the mushrooms to the side. All right, spinach, you're going away. We got just what we needed, just a little hint of spinach. Gotta get fresh ginger. Look at that. Shaved it up the other day. This handy thing from 23 years ago. Look at the shredder. We'll have this ready to shred on the meal when we finish up. One more thing. Alan Pavanda gave us Alan's Gourmet garlic powder. It's great. 8 different combinations, great garlic, very tasty. And we'll put that in there. Well, I hope you guys are enjoying this great day. This show will be up as early as tomorrow, maybe by Friday. And we're gonna put this in, get the rice cauliflower cooked up, and ...90 seconds. If you want to catch that, Nick, you want to see. ...90 seconds, 1 minute 30. And we just let it run around a little. The tea is ready. So I'll need you to back up there for me, Nick. Thank you for your help. All right, here we go, folks. Tea ball in. Penguin up. And that's how easy. Just pour it. I like a nice full cup. Put it back. It's very hot. So it does heat it up to 175 degrees. And we're good. I got to get a little plate for my presentation when I put that tea ball out on the table. That's for the presentation for Penguin. To all you Penguin fans, there he is. All right, scissors. We don't need them anymore. Spoon back. Need a fork to eat with. All right, it's just heating up nice. You only got about 15 seconds left on that riced cauliflower. Watch your fingers when you pull it out. I got thick skin, so it doesn't bother me. Here we go. There it is. If you want to catch this, Nick, there's an art to that. Look at that. Stands right up. I'm done with it. Then we flatten it out. You know how I like to present it well. Mmm. And you can taste a little bit while you're eating. With your got other people, you may not be able to taste as much. My great neoprene gloves. Let's see what we got here. Start the thermometer. You want to come in, Nick? We have a winner. Whoa, it's really well cooked there. All right, the spinach is ready. We're ready to maneuver around, folks. All right, we'll shut that. Shut the oven off. All right, we're getting serious right now. This is crunch time for you. Look at that nice piece of salmon. Bella mushrooms. All right, Bella. Whoa. Darn that. Accidents happen. Little rinse. Whoa, that's warm. All right, let's see what we got next. All right, we got some onion. Put that out there. Another onion the other way. This onion came apart a little, so we'll put it right there. And a little piece of center. Pile the onion up. Butternut squash. Look at that, wonderful. All right. Very tasty. All right, some yellow squash. We're gonna have to overlap a little. Put some squash there. And we got some zucchini. We'll put a couple around here. A couple more here. And a yellow squash. Right there. All right, the spinach. Whew. All righty. Little spinach for color. Looks yellow with the green. All right. Let's see, we're about ready to wrap this up. Let's get over here. Let me just see. All right, shredded ginger. See how it flies around, but that ginger's a good digestive helper. And there we go. Garlic, be generous with the garlic. All right, rainbow peppercorn. Okay, you know what's coming. Virgin olive oil, organic. Little drizzle. All right, here we go. Tea's done. Stop the timer. Here's our finished product, a new record. I think it was 1948. Here it is, sockeye salmon, spinach on the top, fresh shredded ginger, garlic, and virgin olive oil. We got butternut squash, zucchini, red onions, bella mushrooms, yellow squash, and we got riced cauliflower. Looks like rice, tastes like cauliflower, virgin olive oil all around. Penguins there, if you can see them. There he is, loose leaf green tea. Delicious. Thank you for watching. Thank you for being a fan. Thanks for your great feedback. See you next month. Every third Wednesday of each month, the Speedy Gourmet comes up with another meal.